Chat, did y'all know there's a 1v1 court in the city? I don't look at the map, nor do I look at the city. So I just found out there's a 1v1 court over here. So what's the first thing I do? I go straight over there. And I realize there's nothing but pretty good players in here. I had like 3 games against scrubs and the rest was pretty good people that knew what they were doing with the game. This guy is undersized and I'm oversized, so this is a weird matchup. He too fast for me, I'm too big for him. This is such a weird game, but this turned out so balanced. What he had in speed, I made up for in size. Like, that balanced out our both of our play styles very much. He got a steal on me. And he was not getting chased down blocked, bro. He had to have like 90 dunking. There should have been no way these dunks ain't hit rim. That's what I was banking on. Me having this 90 block so I could chase him down at some point. But I could not catch this guy once he got that head start to the rim. And that right there, that made me so mad. Because how was that an open shot when I'm on him? And I tried to get a 3 back, but he was pretty close. Hey, so we should settle for the spinner. Come on. Reese is setting for the spinner. Let's go, boy. He in front of me. Reese ain't going for none of that. You too little down there, boy. You better take me back out here. He trying to create space, but he using speed. That's what I'm looking for, that chase down. But his little speed self got the rebound. I'm mad. He sat there for a couple minutes trying to regain stamina. No time on the shot clock. Still burns around me. Speed demon, bro. Absolute speed demon. Keeping the ball where he can't reach. Behind the back, crossing. I'm breaking his ankles for me to be so big. Don't act like Reese ain't got no crossovers. He hit me with a similar cross. Got me to jump wide open. That's the speed. Y'all see, I was trying to chase down his dunks all game, so I had to jump behind him. But he baited me and got a 3-point. He was taking his little 3-point shots when he could get him. And like, that's why I was trying to chase him down, but I'm not getting any of my blocks. Got him to come forward. Reese run around him. Beautiful, simple play. We have our 3v3 takeovers on. I don't even have my single player takeovers. That's how I just came out here to play. I wasn't even thinking like that. And I can't get any chase down blocks. Money just having his way. So all I need is this layup and I get double takeover. Booyah. Now Reese activates double take and now we can shoot from limitless range, and he's too short to even contest my shot. He got the lockdown takeover. I don't know which one that is. I don't know what lockdown takeovers do. I haven't seen them. We knew he liked to take threes. I thought he was going to go for a 3 to end the game, so I jump at that. Nothing I can do right there. And like I just said, I'm in takeover limitless range. He's too short. That was never going to be contested. Reese needs to stop here because I haven't missed a shot yet. As long as I get the ball in my hand, the ball in the net, and he just blows by me and I don't get no chase down. That boy was way too fast. That boy was way too fast. I literally can't even say I did anything wrong because I haven't missed a shot and he got one steal. That was almost a perfect game. Welcome to the Sauce Mob. Hit that button that say subscribe and join the ride. You feel me? Check. As we all know, next gen, more importantly than current gen, is plagued by the 90 steal. So if anybody who don't have 90 steal on their perimeter defending build, you pretty much just at a disadvantage defensively, because all you gotta do is press square and you're most likely getting a steal. So 2K has finally made an address talking about the 90 stealing situation. Here we go. Minor badge balancing update will go live for current and new gen tomorrow morning, containing the following. There's going to be a slight reduction in the effectiveness of mismatch expert and blinders, and increased effectiveness of unpluckable. No patch download is required for the update. Me personally, I have never used mismatch expert on current gen, and my build is 6'10 on next gen, so mismatch wouldn't even work for me because I'm pretty tall. So I never used mismatch on current or next gen, so I don't know how overpowered that badge was. For any guards that played like that, let me know down in the comments. And as far as blinders, I didn't even know it was that overpowered. I just thought that's how it's supposed to work. Anyway, chat, mismatch expert and blinders are getting nerfed, and the unpluckable badge is getting boosted. I have unpluckable for my center on next gen on silver. That's the highest I can get, so let's hope that silver keeps me protected, because other than that, your boy down bad. Mike Wang says, we're trying to be extra careful to keep our day one gameplay balance intact as best as we can. So these are pretty conservative badge tweaks. Please keep the feedback coming. Chat, let me know what y'all think about these badge changes after the first week of the game. Keep in mind, there's 5 more weeks left in this first season. Seasons are every 6 weeks, and this is the first change. Me personally, I would like a change to badges once every season with the season update. That's just how I look at it. But I definitely want patch notes and changes to happen season by season. You see how they boosted Unpluckable. You see how they nerfing Mismatch Expert. I would like these type of things to go in effect throughout the seasons. That's the point of the seasons, to keep the game fresh and new, to make people have to change around their badges. Chat, as we all know, once you max out your build, your badges, you can change them as much as you want on current gen. And on next gen, as soon as you get them, you can change them around. So if a badge becomes useless, if a badge become overpowered, you can instantly swap to it, because that's the purpose of the game. That's why badges can be changed on the fly. So me personally, I love the fact that they're tuning and tweaking badges. I want this to keep happening, but I want it to happen throughout the start of a season. So like when seasons come around, you play with a new meta setup, so we keep having a refreshed game every season. That's the way I look at it. And just to look at the 90 steal situation, y'all just saw me play a 1v1 in the warehouse. That was a warm up to get me ready for the stage. And let me show you what happened in my very first stage game. Chat, when I'm talking in like the intros and I'm explaining like badges and like updates to the game, do I talk to y'all like y'all kids? Do it sound like I'm talking to a kid? Because that's what I think, because y'all are childish and you know that. So anyway, we out here on the 1v1 court. This the first time I ever came out here, and y'all already know what time it is, bruh. Reese was warming up out there. I lost to that undersized player. He was too fast for me. So we're gonna see what a player more my size I could do with that. This boy, I think that he like 6'8. He gotta be like 6'7 minimum. Like the lowest he could be is 6'7, but he don't even look 6'7. Anyway, he got the speed. So that step back right there is gonna be the number one problem of this video. As y'all gonna see, that's his favorite move on this, because I don't know what this was right here. But anyway, that's gonna be his favorite move, because the step back opens up enough space to shoot the shot, and it gives him a speed boost to blow past you once you step forward to contest his shot. So if I don't step forward, he can pull up, and if I step forward too much, he can walk around me. So that step back right there is gonna be his main exploit, and he gonna keep going to it. So I gotta step up, and he's trying to get around. Good miss, but for whatever reason, I don't get a rebound, and for whatever reason, that goes in. So right now, we're feeling a little cheated. We don't feel like we're losing the skill at all. We getting cheated. He's not outplaying me. Reese perfectly guards him, and I'm backing up as I realize he pump fake. Hi, ay, ay, bro. This game is frustrating, to say the least. The thing that the warehouse tricked me, I thought we was gonna switch and get ball, because in a warehouse, after you score, you give the other person a ball. I wasn't ready for a person to keep ball after they score. So now this is our first time getting the ball. I'm trying to hurry up before he get back up, but that rebound animation took too long. Reese showing y'all here ISO center, and that right there was a red flag for me. After he I have Unpluckable on no, I have Gather, the layup thing. There's a thing to protect your layups. I got the badge to protect you from getting stripped on a layup. But the fact he stripped me on a layup lets me know that he had a high steal rating. And he keep doing these step backs to get that shot, but he's not even good enough to time his release. So I don't know what's going on out here. And now he's not pressing square, so we had no idea at this current moment that we were dealing with one of the 90 steal players. He wasn't pressing square. It wasn't until a little bit into the game he started actually pressing square. There you go. And right there, I think that's what triggered his brain to think, I can strip this guy whenever I want to, and I'm not shooting my jump shot because I'm trying to make things happen. Good lay, Reese. Somehow I blow that. Jump again. Give me a free layup. I don't actually end up going back up, so now we're tired with no shot clock, so there's nothing I can do anymore. Yeah, this is just a bad look for Reese. This is just a bad look. this is on the struggle bus. This is Reese on the struggle bus right now. We're trying to get warmed up, and we out here going out stupid. Now he got his takeover, and he definitely got the lockdown take, and he's going to start spamming square. This is the issue of the game right now, is that it really don't take skill defensively. It's just about who's pressing their square button the most with that 90 steal. Me, I only get my steal to 70 because I'm 6'10". So that's why I said, if y'all was to remake my build, you would have to get an 80 steal, a 90, some way to get a higher steal than what I got. Tried to do a step back, but I got the wrong animation, so now I'm just locked in here doing whatever this is. Let's go. I'm actually protecting the ball a whole lot better than I thought I did, because it get a whole lot worse throughout this game. Reese got no stamina, so there's no way that shot going in. Chat, we just bad looks out here, bro. We over dribbling, we doing too much. Money is doing whatever this is. Them spins ain't working on me, buddy. And he got the 90 still, so we ain't going nowhere. Unpluckable only on silver for me, so hopefully this upgrade stops that from happening, but I'm highly doubting it. I don't think that I could do anything to protect myself. I really don't think I'm even getting stripped on triple threats. That's how bad this get. I can't even do a triple threat move, bro. It's over with for me. Y'all can see it right here. As long as this update helped my silver unpluggable, we should be good, but I highly doubt that. Money keep hitting that step back, trying to get the shot, so I'm having to respect that step back. I have to. Keep guarding him. He ain't doing nothing with me, and I'm not doing nothing with him on offense, bro. We both just out here looking stupid. Good defense, Reese, easy board. There was nothing I could do out here, because every time I tried to dribble close to him, I would get stripped. And now my stamina drained, and now I definitely can't do nothing with no stamina. But Reese IQ let go of L2, and he just walks right through me. That's too much IQ, bro. That's way too much IQ, bro. I don't know what else to tell you. I'm getting stripped on triple threat, so we trying to make our movements faster and more precise. Didn't get the angle to the rim I wanted in the post. Doing too much standing around trying to reset my stamina. Bro, there's nothing I can do. My stamina draining too fast, and my moves aren't effective enough, because I'm not used to playing 1v1s. I'm used to playing the 3v3 court, where I get to dribble up the court as my big man. My 1-to-1 game ain't where it's supposed to be. Reese out here losing an easy winnable game. I gotta blame myself. His stealing made it annoying for the most part, because I couldn't catch a rhythm. I was trying to get comfortable dribbling, but like, I can't get comfortable, because every time I try to reset, he's stripping me. There's nothing I can do, and his offense is just straight up trash off the fact that he can't do nothing with me, but I can't do nothing with him, because I'm trying to set myself up and I get stripped every time. So we just literally stuck at a stalemate, and he making the most dumbest layups over me. We're stuck at a stalemate because I'm trying to set up my dribbling, and he's stripping me every time, and he can't do anything offensively. Easy block again. Ball hit rim, so now I gotta take it back. And look at me when I try to reset myself to get in front of the rim. All he gotta do is press square. I'm on my way to driving to the rim. He can get a steal. At that point, there's nothing I can do, bro. The stealing is too ridiculous in the game. I'm trying to get a simple run. I knew he reaching, so I gotta hold L2. I'm trying to set up and go. I'm trying to do something quick. So now I'm thinking, you know what? It's time to just start shooting jumpers. Reese gotta bring this game back one way or another. I can't even hit my triple threat spin. I can't even spin out the triple threat, bro. There was nothing I could do from the start of that game. His steal rating was too high. My unpluckable wasn't strong enough. Or the game just broken off steals, and y'all know that already. So there was nothing Reese could do. Hopefully this update that's coming helps me. If not, it helps me. At least it helps the rest of the community have more security over the ball. Because right now the game is at a ridiculous place where everybody getting ripped and nobody's having a good time dribbling. That's a fact.